All right, guys, welcome to episode 40 of Dope Talk TV. It's yours truly, Low Key. Got John here with me.
Yo,
appreciate everybody that's rocking with us, liking, subscribing, sharing, thumbs up, all that good shit, guys. We appreciate it from the bottom of our heart, so continue to do that. But yeah, man, we're back with another episode. John, how you feeling today, boy?
Feeling good, you know what I mean? Had a good day, chilling.
My dog got yatted. My dog got yatted today. I see you, bro.
Yeah, a little, you know, I'll show you guys later on when it's finished.
Yeah, it's, you know, something light.
It's nothing too crazy.
Yeah, it was straight, man. Today was a chill day, you know what I'm saying? Chilling with my homegirl, Cindy, about to go shoot some guns, and there was a fucking 2-hour wait. So he said, fuck that, and just went and ate.
Nah.
But it's been a chill day. Can't really fucking complain.
Yeah, I like to go shooting. That's fun.
Yeah, it's super fun. But yeah, man. John, I say that we've been friends for a while. You know what I mean?
Yeah, we've been friends for a while, bro.
Yeah. I can say to you, one of my brothers is not just a friend.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And
likewise.
I would say that, you know what I'm saying, we're pretty comfortable with each other.
Yeah.
But some people get a little too comfortable.
Nah,
now.
Just a little bit. just a little bit too comfy. You know what I mean?
Let's talk about it.
Oh, man, I was chilling, man. I was driving. You know, I have it on
just
Bluetooth.
Just cooling, bro.
Just riding. It was a normal day.
Normal day.
Dude called me. He's like, yo, mira papi. Yo, what are you doing?
Tato.
What are you doing? I'm like, yo, I'm chilling. You know, I'm here. I have him on speaker. You know, and all I hear is, you know, some girl screaming. You know, clapping. You know, clapping. I'm
cheeks
like,
clapping.
And I'm driving. I'm like, yo, what is that? Like, bro, is this guy watching porn? Like, I had to like stay on the line like a little bit longer, just to like, you know. I was like, what? And I was just trying to
just
see what that was.
Just to process what the fuck was going on.
I just want to know, like, it's okay. It's okay to watch porn, but
of
just
course.
Like, but why? Like, why are you gonna call me? Like, are
no,
you jacking
no, no.
off on
no,
calling?
No, bro. First of all, whether you're about to just finish or you're in the middle of it, don't call me around then.
No.
Like, finish, do what you gotta do,
don't
my
wank
G,
your
and
shit.
Then hit me up.
Yeah.
Don't wank your shit on the phone with me.
Nah.
Watching porn, like, if that's some normal shit.
Nah, I can't. Nah, that's not okay. That's not okay. So I felt violated, bro. I felt violated in a way.
God, what if it was just him and his homeboys just running train on some cheeks, bro?
Shit. He was probably like, yo, hey.
Tato, Mali.
Yo, I'll hit you up later. All right,
facts.
Bro. All right.
But
that's
facts,
weird.
Though. All jokes aside, my nigga. There's like, there has to be boundaries in friendships. You know
what
I'm saying? It's just like, that's a little too far, my nigga. Do what you do. I'm not going to judge you. We all watch porn.
Seriously.
I don't give a fuck who the fuck you are.
Yeah.
Like, the majority of people watch porn, but... Nigga, I'm not gonna call you while in the middle of a porn session. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
that's
nah.
kind of weird, dog.
Nah, that is kind of weird. And I don't know why people think, like, I watch porn. Like, I ain't gonna lie, I do. But, like, I don't think it's okay for, like, I feel like I don't need a fake ass. I don't need fake titties. I don't need it.
Not facts.
I've seen it.
Bro, it's just, it's unrealistic, man. Like, this, the expectations of people that watch porn and then they go and have sex. You know what I'm saying? People that watch too much porn and don't get a lot of sex. And then when they have sex, they're like, what the fuck? Like they're let down. Because most, like, sex, bro, is like, normal people have sex the normal way. They're not sitting here doing all this extra shit, fucking, like, acrobatics and putting their legs behind their head.
Yeah.
Like, nigga, it's just normal sex.
Yeah. Like, just take care of yourself. We're not saying, like, have obese, like, just let yourself go, but like, you should take care of yourself, obviously. Like, that's an attraction. But like, for you to have something fake to put
I
up
mean, you it, don't it, need it, man.
Yeah.
Like, if that's what you want to do because you want to do it, cool. But if it's something that you're doing because, like, you feel pressured by society, like, oh, men aren't gonna chase after me if I don't have a big ass or big boobs. If that's why you're getting surgery, bro, then you need to deal with the real issues. You know what I'm saying? And that's just you wanting to be accepted.
And being lazy, like, too. Because, like, you don't wanna work for it.
Yeah. I mean, there's certain things you can't work for, like bigger titties.
No, that's different.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, like, an ass, like, you could do some squats. You could get yourself in shape. You know what I mean? Like, you could do different things.
That's true.
But it's just really unrealistic,
it's a
man.
Mirage.
It's
a mirage.
Facts. But it's unrealistic, man. You can't expect, like, real sex to be like how it is in porn, bro. It's just not really how it goes.
Nah.
Most of the time.
That's not how it goes at all. But that kind of makes me a little bit upset. You know, that's one of the things that make me upset.
Yeah, bro.
We were talking about being upset.
Yeah, being angry and shit.
Like that. That kind of throws you off sometimes. You know,
being angry and needing therapy for it, dog. Yeah. Like sometimes, bro.
Yeah, you might need to get bro. There's types of anger, bro. There's levels. It's like it's not
facts. You know, it's like you get you know upset, and then you start getting pissed off. Then you get fucking mad. Then you go up to, like, rage. And then you go out to,
ballistic, like black.
Like, yeah. Like, you're just ready to fucking stab everybody.
Yeah. Like, isn't there a show called Snapped? Like, there's a just show about that. You know, people just snap and people just...
what it's about? Yeah, I've never watched that
shit. One of my friends told me about it. His wife watches it. That's really what it is. And like, it worries him. It worries him because he's like, bro, like, I don't know why that's her favorite show. And it's true because I heard her say it in front of me.
Weird, bro.
She's like, oh, that's my favorite show.
Some people have some weird shows that they really like all this murder shit. Like, yeah. I almost got away with it and all this other shit. It's like, holy fuck, shit. Bitch. Y'all, like, females are on some other shit when it comes to shows like that. Yeah, it's like, why y'all really watching this shit?
They want me to think when I be watching these shows.
I learned how to kill somebody and get away with it today. It's like, what are you trying to tell me right now?
Nah, for real.
Are you trying to put some fucking rat poison in my tomato soup or some shit?
Nah, you know what? You know what? I don't trust nobody cooking for me, bro. You know why? Because I see some shit, bro. I see my mom. I've seen my mom with her past boyfriends. I ain't gonna lie. Listen, I hope my mom's not watching this. But the other guy don't matter because he's not in the picture no more. But you know what I mean? But
not facts.
Nah. Nah, but I've seen some shit, man. Like, my mom told me, like, yo, she put some, like, rotten shit, like, and put it in his food. Because he pissed her off, you know? And it's like, yo, how do you get to that level? Do you want him to be in pain? Do you want him to get an ulcer? Like, what's wrong with you?
Why don't you just kick him out? Before you go put rotten food in somebody's
plate. And he fucking dies or something.
So let him know that you don't like him. Just tell him, hey, bitch, I don't like you. Get out.
You know what I saw today? Speaking of fucking snapping and dying for no reason on stupid shit. Fucking, I saw a video of somebody boxing. And you could tell it was like Dominican Republic. Somewhere out, you know, on the island. You could tell.
Right.
They were speaking Spanish and shit. And I was like, man, they boxing out in the street. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. All right. Well, someone gets knocked out. They're going to get hurt. Thinking, in my opinion, the motherfucker swung at him, hit him right in the fucking head, knocked out. All I saw was, like, you know how it shows videos and then, like, you could slide through of, like, the different events? It was different pictures. So, like, under that video was a picture of, like, him there, like this. And then there was, like, stiff, bro.
Like
stiff.
A fucking knot the size of a fist?
No, and then, like, a red mark right here, like, from inside of his head. It was, like, a red mark from inside, so it was internal bleeding. You could tell he got hit in the head once, and then he just, that was it.
And he died?
And he died. He died. Yeah.
My God, dog.
It's very disturbing. It was.
Nah, bro.
It was today.
That's why you gotta be. Nah, bro. I tell people all the time, bro. You gotta be careful, deadass.
Nah, random
you go
shit.
Out, you go out to, you know what I'm saying, thinking you're going to have a good night, you end up getting into a fight, you know what I'm saying, that fight, one person gets hit the wrong way, falls and hits their head on the curb, now it's a murder case.
Seriously.
Because they're dead. Like, crazy shit like that happens all the time, bro, you got to be careful. But sorry, man, damn, rest in peace to that guy.
Yeah, like, yeah, that's he was fun. Young too, man. And the wrong thing that they were doing was picking his head up when he was down. Like, shivering,
that's,
you
like,
gotta leave him there.
That's why people don't, like, bro, if you're not medically trained, bro, get somebody who is. You know what I'm saying? If you don't feel comfortable and you really don't know what the fuck you're doing, don't touch him. Because you moving his head the wrong way, moving his head or his neck the wrong way, bro, you could fuck him up for life.
For real.
You could paralyze him for life. You could do certain shit to him that you didn't even know you could do. So, yeah, guys, leave the fucking medical shit to the professionals. If you don't know what the fuck you're doing,
like
you can fuck somebody up.
CPR, you do the wrong shit and
you
kill them?
Yeah, you break their fucking ribs and they can't breathe still. Like, what the fuck?
You fucking push the cherry down his fucking throat even farther. You know what I'm saying? You don't know what the fuck he was choking on, you know?
Like, nah, facts, bro. Talk about choking, though, buddy.
Oh.
I'll tell you what. There's a fucking question,
that's,
bro.
That was good. That was a good segue.
That was a good segue. There's a question, bro, that I wanted to know, you know what I mean? Just for you guys out there. You ladies, too. Matter of fact, you ladies, too. Can you survive off of head only?
Nah. And, I mean, it depends on how good the head is. Because you know what I mean? Because there's some head that you just get and you're just like, Jesus Christ, Lord, God bless you, Jesus, Lord.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
You're fucking praying.
Jesus.
And praising.
Please don't go nowhere. And they always do.
Yeah, I got fucking, oh, they always do.
Yeah, they always end up somewhere. Yeah, you know.
But they come back.
No, they come back. Sometimes they don't. Back. I've had some, you know. I had some.
That's on you, though. It depends on what you do.
Hey. I've met some players that were females too.
Oh, no. Listen, the biggest players that I know are females.
Yeah, facts.
I met some dudes, you know what I'm saying, my homeboys, that they do the damn thing too. Yeah. But girls, I don't know how they do it. But like we've talked about it before. They have their own code.
Yeah.
They have their own code.
They got their own language and shit. But like Bisca Bargain, I don't fucking know. Their own gang sounds.
Like they clap their wooden shoes and they all fucking hear and meet up in the bathroom. I don't know. It's weird. It's fucking weird. But they get it done.
They clap their shoes.
Yo. Like Dorothy. Yo. And they all appear in the bathroom.
Nah, that's crazy.
And make the move for the night.
Nah, but they're the dirtiest. Like out of gender wise, like who like keeps up the most? Like I know women are gonna fight this. I know.
Nah,
I know.
Nah.
But listen,
women can't be in denial about being the biggest players. They are the biggest player. They play more than guys, bro.
Facts.
Real talk. And they get away with. They're smooth criminals, man.
Yeah.
They're smooth. Like guys, we're fucking stupid.
Yeah.
We get caught quick.
Yeah.
Like we won't even know who the fuck. Like she'll just come up with a random name just to see what's up. Who's Marissa? And you're like, oh, fuck, shit, friend from high school. Whole time, she didn't know there was a Marissa. You're just a fucking idiot, and you just sold yourself out.
Yeah.
Guys are stupid like that.
Yeah,
we
I know.
Like that. But
I
girls
know.
Are
sometimes
like,
they be like, oh, that's my cousin, you know, and it's not.
That's my cousin.
It's not your cousin. She's banging him.
The whole time, the girl's DMing
I heard
girl.
A story of a guy. You know who told me this? My mom's fucking friend told me this.
Fuck
She's like, you know, she brought it up. She was just like, yo, like, I had a cousin of mine that he got played. Like he's single. He has no kids. He has nothing. It's because he got played in the past with a chick. He let her stay. You know what I mean? Whatever, at the house with her. You know, everything was good for a couple months. And then like he came back from work one day and there was a guy sleeping on his couch.
On his couch.
Yeah, and he was just like, yo, baby. What's going on? What the fuck is this? Like, who is this? And he's just like, oh, yeah, what the fuck is that? That's what I would be thinking. What the fuck?
Not thinking. I'm whooping ass all through the house. Whoever the fuck is in there is getting fucking hands put on him.
Facts. That's what I was thinking. And she's just like, oh, like, you know, he talked to her, whatever. And she was just like, oh, like, nah, that's my cousin. He had no place to stay. He's from Puerto Rico. Blah, 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 blah. And he's like, oh, well, you know, next time you should have told me. You know what I mean? And then let it be.
Bro,
next.
You and your cousin can fucking skedaddle.
Y'all can get the fuck out of here.
I don't know what I'm saying.
Yo,
get the fuck out of here. In every language I can fucking say it in.
Yo, get out of here. That's what I would be like. You know, pack your stuff, get out.
Be like, well, listen, I feel for you and your cousin, but y'all need to find a spot because this ain't it.
Nah, but dude. So dude.
My cousin.
So dude lets him stay there for like 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
You got me.
He comes back.
All the way fucked up. And that's not her cousin, is it? They fucking on his couch, huh?
Nah, he comes back. He comes back from work and shit. I don't know how you could be this gullible. You guys know what's gonna happen. So he gets in there. He's all sweaty and shit. He's all sweaty. She's all sweaty, and you know she's in the shower. And he's like, "Who is this?" And you know she's like,
"It was her other cousin."
He's like, "Yo, y'all need to get out. This is not your fucking cousin." Blah 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 blah.
No, bro.
And that was it. And he's never been with anybody since. No kids, no nothing.
Oh my god, dog. That's a fuck situation.
That's a fuck situation. But,
at the same but
you're
time,
gullible.
Es por pendejo.
Yeah, you're gullible. And you're fucking.
No por pendejo. Like, straight up. There's no other word because it's like, nigga.
You got a rock for a fucking brain.
Nigga, from the first fucking time I walk in my crib and see that nigga there. Cousin or not. Get out.
I don't care if you're her cousin. I don't care if you're her fucking dog.
We don't house immigrants.
He's Puerto Rican.
Nah, that's fucked up. Nah, I'm Puerto Rican too. But yeah, nah, dead ass. Like, nah, dead ass. Like, I'm up a tanta gente, mi gente. You gotta go.
Nah, you gotta go. Yeah.
There's only two bedrooms and there's two people here, so.
Yo, first
fuck
of all,
outta here.
Let's talk about how you were sleeping on that fucking couch.
Oh my fucking god. Yo, every time we go to Miami, dog.
Yo, I don't like Miami.
Shit ever, bro. I was sleeping on this pull out couch, bro. It was like this fucking. It was a bed inside a couch, my nigga. You pull it out, for those of you who've never seen those. And that shit had fucking craters in it, my nigga.
Bro, that shit probably had mad fucking trannies rammed on.
Bro, I don't know what you had. Damn, bitch, why you have to... God damn it, bro. Nah, but
that's why I slept on the floor. There was
like some big ass fucking holes in the bed, bro. I roll over. And I'm big, bro. And I'm falling
he's
in that
7
shit.
Feet. What are you? What are you? Like
6'6", yeah.
God damn, he's 7 feet tall. So mind you that heavy ass giant rolling in the bed.
Oh, fuck, bitch. Everybody can't be fucking Lord Farquaad size. Nah. You know what I mean? Fuck out of here.
Hey, I'm not sure. I'm not sure.
A chair fucking stepper to get to the top of the fridge and shit. Nah,
when I slept on the fucking floor and my hip was sore. That was a bar.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you what, honestly, bro, halfway through the night, bro, we should have switched. You should have won on the bed, I should have won on the floor, because that bed was trash. And I was thinking, I'm like, yo, maybe I should have took the floor, dog. No. This shit, like, I'm telling you, bro, your legs are above your head when you're laying. Like, it's weird, bro. You're like,
that bitch was getting missionary on the fucking back end. Like.
Nah, they broke the springs off of that fucking couch,
God,
man.
God damn.
Straight up.
Nah.
But not, like, besides that, Miami was all right, man. At least the pool was open, you know? Because if we would have went and then the pool was closed and the beach was closed.
Imagine if we didn't have masks.
Oh, my God, bro. That was the worst shit. That was the worst part about it.
We would have to use card every time to get gas. I mean, we only spent $20 to get out there.
Facts. Not facts, yeah. Not focus, man.
Nah, man. I'm telling you, get a focus, guys.
That shit puts in work, bro.
Facts. I had one for like 7 years.
That shit makes you go. $20, bro. You out across the whole state.
For real?
Dead ass.
I mean, I still got it. It's just not working anymore.
Fix that shit, bro. I've told you about that shit a million times. Just fix that shit. Whip that bitch till it blows up again.
Nah, that's crazy.
For real.
Man, did you hear about, man, all these people partying now? They don't give a fuck.
Bro, people are tired of being cooped up in the house, dog. Ain't nobody trying to sit here fucking do the same bullshit for 6 months straight. Like, niggas is out.
Even Joe Rogan, he said it when we were watching him. He said the same. He was like, bro, he's getting pissed. He's like, man,
He's like, I don't know how long I could stay in fucking Cali, bro. He's like, I'm out.
Nah, for real.
He wasn't playing either. I mean, people get tired of it, bro. People get fucking tired of it. I know I am. But at the same time, I don't know,
life is not really going to change too much for me.
What do you mean?
Like, I feel like I'm going to stay home.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's not even that. Like, that's how I was living before this shit happened. You know me, though.
Yeah.
I was social distancing a year before this corona bullshit happened.
Facts.
That's a fact.
Yeah.
So, it's like, who gives a fuck? But there's a lot of people that's not their lifestyle. They're not the people that, you know, are at home every night and just chilling and just enjoying their own privacy. Like, there's people that really like going out like that. And they're tired, bro. And they're going out. They're going to go out. They don't give a fuck about rules, masks. None of that shit.
Yeah.
Like, they out.
Yeah, that's true.
For real.
Nah, man. I didn't know, like, bro, my mom, she took out the jet skis this weekend and shit, and she told me that they got 3 tickets. Yeah.
Damn.
Because there's a no wave zone. I didn't know that.
The fuck
you
is
go
a
to,
no
you
wave
gotta,
zone?
You can't make no waves in the fucking, because of the manatees and shit, so you gotta go a certain
speed. Oh, damn.
You gotta make sure you got a fire extinguisher. Like, they had that, but, like, you gotta have that. You gotta have flares. Like, there's a lot of things, like, and rules. Like, yeah, it was crazy.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That makes me not want to get a jet ski.
It makes me not want to go. Imagine if you're just, like,
intoxicated. What the fuck? Like, what if I just accidentally hit the throttle a little too hard and now I'm getting a fucking ticket?
What if you're just...
What if I thought I was about to get attacked by a fucking alligator and I had to hit it real quick?
Yeah?
Now I'm getting a ticket.
What if I was getting attacked by anything?
Facts. Nah. I don't know, bro. I mean, fuck it. Take it out to the beach, though. I'm pretty sure the beach, you'll fucking haul ass on that shit. Nobody really gives a fuck.
Nah. Yeah. You're right. That's true.
I take it to the beach.
Yeah. I mean, it's smooth. I'll pull up looking like a fucking fat piece of shit. Fucking running and
nah,
shit.
Nah, big facts, bro. Nah, yeah. My fucking large fat ass gets on that shit, bro. I might tip that bitch over.
Fucking drinking Coronas and shit. Fucking getting fucked up. Did you hear about the people getting ran over at the beach, like, years back? Like, I don't understand how you run somebody over. You know, Daytona's the only one that actually has, like...
Like, yeah... you could park on the beach and shit.
Yeah, with NASCAR, you know, because they did NASCAR on the beach back in the day.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's how they first started before the fucking stadium.
Wait, they used to race on the beach?
Yes.
No, they fucking did.
I'll show you an old picture. I'll pull it up right here, guys. It's an old picture. If you guys didn't know, NASCAR back in the day, they used to race on the beach. And it would do a loop. So one side would be road and the other side would be sand. That's crazy. I didn't know that.
That's fucking kind of trash,
too. It is trash, but imagine how many wrecks and how many people drove into the fucking ocean. Going that speed. I mean, I don't know what speed they were going at. You know, probably not 200, but they were going fast.
Nah. Them bitches were hauling ass.
You hit a pothole, run over something.
60 miles an hour going through the sand, and you hit a fucking...
You see a sea turtle, you're like, fuck!
You hit a fucking sandcastle you didn't see.
Nah, for real. I don't even know if they had people on the beach during that time, but... If they did, that would be dangerous.
I don't see why they would. I'm pretty sure they wouldn't.
Nah, it's only like 2 mile, 3 mile stretch.
Yeah, but fuck that, bro. Driving through the sand is so trash.
Yeah.
Like, why would you want to do it on purpose while you're racing?
imagine getting stuck. That's trash. Getting stuck, like, in the sand. I hate that, going to the beach. That's why I never go on the beach. I remember trying to fucking...
Now, I'm going to park where there's fucking cement at. And then I'm going to walk my fat ass to the beach.
That's why people bring, like, planks of wood and shit. Fucking, you know, put it in.
I mean, I don't know. It depends on the vehicle, man. Yeah. Like, if you have, like, a Jeep, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's certain vehicles where it's like, okay, you'll be straight in the sand or whatever. But, nigga, JDM Beach Day.
Why do you guys go on the beach?
Funniest fucking shit alive. Niggas can't even get on the beach without ripping their bumpers off and shit.
Nah, for real. Like, nah, that's trash. That's trash. I don't like going there.
Yeah, JD, I mean, it's cool, like, seeing all the different cars and shit, but at the same time, it's like, whoa,
bring it to the streets. Where it belongs.
I get it, bro. I get it. It's a vibe. It's cars a vibe. And the beach and the bitches and the booze and all the bees. But...
Yeah, like a truck rally, that would make sense. A Jeep, you know?
Yeah.
You know, but like...
Yeah, but nah. JDM, nigga, go to the track.
Yeah, that's where you're supposed to be at.
Go to the track, bro. It'll be all right.
Take off that big muffler you got.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie, bro. That's one thing I never cared for, like... Fucking souping up a Honda.
Yeah.
That's like every Hispanic's dream around here. I don't get it.
No, don't put $50,000 into a car. They'll don't even got a house.
Yo, bro, listen. They'll be at their mom's with 30 racks in a car that looks like it's worth $1,200.
Nah.
Yeah. You know exactly what I'm talking about.
Nah, that's trash.
I mean, the car runs.
Yeah.
It'll run, bro. It's quick, but it looks beat as fuck. And all the money went straight into the motor. And then, like, it's a Honda. So, like, 3 weeks later, that nigga get his shit stolen and shit. Like, it's... Hondas are just too much, bro.
You ever see the people that take off the steering wheels?
Yeah.
And they can walk with it?
You ever seen the people that fucking put their own steering wheel and just take that shit anyway?
Nah, bro. You know what? I'm going to take that and put it on mine.
Like, I already stole one from the last car.
I can't steal the car, but I can steal the steering wheel.
Oh, my God, dog. You're a piece of shit if you're showing any of that.
Nah, that's trash. I've seen people on like on the sites and shit like that, like Facebook, like people like complaining, like, yo, like people really steal like anything. They'll steal anything, I promise.
Anything.
They'll steal.
You don't remember when we pulled up to Miami and the nigga got his fucking tailgate stolen?
Yeah. And fucking took it off just completely.
A Ford F-350. Yeah. Not a 150 or 250. A Ford F-350 got his whole fucking 4.5 foot long tailgate stolen right off the back of his fucking truck. People steal anything if they see, like...
They'll steal anything if it's worth value.
Yeah. Like anything. A like, pen. Bro, anything.
Like, I steal lighters on accident.
On purpose.
On accident. Because I always lose. Like, I'll steal it and then I'll lose it. And then, like, you'll ask for it and then I won't have it. Like, I'm that guy.
Well, I'm the guy that's taking whatever lighter you do have. Whether it's fucking mine or not, you took mine, so now I'm taking yours.
Well, guys.
But oh, now, man. Guys, we're back with another episode. We appreciate everybody that's liking, sharing, subscribing, thumbs up, all that good shit.
Thumbs up.
We see the subscribers going up. We appreciate you guys. The views are going up, so that's great. Soon enough, at 1,000 subscribers, we will have a giveaway, guys. So stay tuned for that and let us know what you guys
like. What do you guys like? Comment. Yeah, maybe at 1,000, we'll get something crazy. Maybe like a little phone. Maybe fucking... It's going to be nice.
Bro. It's something. Yeah, we ain't cheap. So, but yeah, guys, we appreciate everybody. Thank you for rocking. Yours truly, Low Key.
Peace.
Peace.